Good morning from New York. Today's subject, inner mind communication. Where's the love? And are we humane or just apes? I'm going to write that down. Are we humane or just apes? You'd think, well, apes and their behavior well documented by a doctorate of biology, Sapolsky, right? You can feel free to check that fellow out and his findings about apes. One thing about apes, you know, they can be one clan, and then they get divided somehow. They're two different places now. And they have former friends and relatives in each group, right? But they become their own tribe. They've got their own space. When one in the tribe, the one that beats his chest, shakes the bushes the most, and puts down any rivals, a strong ape, he's the leader. And he, when he decides they want more territory, and wants, you know, maybe he wants a few more wives. Anyway, he goes to the attack the other tribe, and then they are vicious to one another. Of course, the people being attacked are defending, and, you know. So all of the bonds of friendship and other relationships, zero. Hate and violence win. So are we like that? Is there any way out of being like that? Well, inner mind communication proposes that we can be more loving. It's certainly a nice goal. It will make us a great deal more humane. But what are you going to do? How are you going to change that? Well, you can't say, I don't play politics. Nah, come on now. Everybody's political. Even at work. Politics is, in a crude form, is how you get the strong ape. It can lead everybody to misery and hate. And you'd say that's not very virtuous. No, it's not. It's not humane. But it's politics. We have politics in our societies. People want to be at the top of the human society food chain. And, you know, there's a lot of reward in that. But the problem is that the really poor become lower down on that food chain. It costs more to be poor than to be rich. It costs a lot. And you're met with, can't afford that. It costs too high. Which leads to a lot of problems. And, you know, I believe a lot of crime. And like, what are you going to do? I was aware of an individual who said that his poor mom, back when marijuana was illegal in that state and in the whole country, sold marijuana to save her home. That's pretty desperate. Well, it's something that a poor person without access to affordable living, who pay more in their fair share in sales tax alone and still oftentimes get a little bit of income tax demanded from them, which goes where? Yeah. Through the government directly into the pockets of the super wealthy, the strong apes. So, and another way you get the strong apes is just a military takeover. That's nice. These people, they're a little more unkind to you than the ones who do it by wealth alone. Kinda. But both things, I mean, you're on the bottom of the food chain. One comedian says it's a club and we're not in it. So, you know, it's a sad, sad thing. How can you even begin to apply inner mind communication when people don't have enough to eat? Remember, I've said before in another video, it's kind of impacting to the extent that good exercise and a good diet is. You know, it's very helpful. It's a kind of mental, emotional set of exercises that are aimed in a spiritual direction, which means attempt to meet human need, which is love, which is spiritual, and to connect to one's own inner higher power of love, the inner artist, I call it, which in reality might just be your brain, and maybe more than that, but who knows. To be spiritual but not religious means you don't jump to conclusions that are unfounded, and yet you follow a spiritual loving path and have a, you know, some respect for the concept of a higher power of love living in you and in others. But how do we get this higher power of love working against our ape-like tendencies? That's a good question. Sometimes the answers can be surprising and complicated. But in essence, if you're going to expand love, then you have the inner mind communication practices, which are all about forms of empathy and awareness, and you have the outer practice of this, the philosophy and the attempt to communicate in enlightened, loving ways, efficient, enlightened, loving ways to other people. Well, how should you set up a society so that that happens more so? Well, first of all, everybody needs a voice. So some kind of democracy. You have the the business of the society, you know, the trade that's necessary for survival, and depends a great deal on trust. Trust in what? Well, trust in an objective empathy in society, which can better take us from from day one forward in helpful ways, and needs a influence from compassionate empathy, which helps to reveal the good things, the caring things that we've experienced, remember those, also to help heal damaged faith and love. You need that. And not that the objective approach doesn't help with that too. These are all loving approaches which do help with damaged faith. But looking at what else trade needs is it needs a divergence of ways of seeing things and approaching things, different perspectives, so that there can be a kind of artfulness in the way things happen. All right? So that means, you know, see the trading element as the business of society. The business of yourself is that dramatic self in you I call the kid. That's your part of you that's most impacted by gains and losses. And it communicates in a healthy society with extended family organizations, which provide the kind of compassionate empathy, supposedly, that we need. And that's like the inner caregiver in ourselves. And it needs a communication and you know, that objective empathy, of course, is in society, is governance. It's the government. So business, or just like the trading center of who you are, the infant and child within you, it's more in touch with survival. That needs objective guidance from the present going forward, and governance helps with that in society. So that's the, like, your inner counselor, except for society. It's, you know, the institution of governance or government. That trade also needs to be communicating with diverse pictures of the world around us to give us a sense of what's going on, not in just in our country or our state or city, but around the world. And that's the media, the institution of the media. So, church needs all of these aspects, but its emphasis is compassionate empathy. Governance needs all of these perspectives, but its emphasis is objective empathy. And the creative self, the artfulness, the artist in you, the creator of all you imagine to be real. This part of you has many different perspectives and needs them in order to be artful. And it expresses that. So that's the media. And these communications, when they're clear and focused, and one perspective not taking over all the others, then you've got a healthy, more of a healthy democracy. The trade can't be totally in control, because in the, you know, you wreck the whole game, like in the game of Monopoly. The whole thing gets wrecked at some point because of the fact that when you gain more wealth, it costs less to be alive and healthy and able than it does if you are poor. If you're higher up on the food chain. So that's the ape-like thing. Is to be power mongering and going for the following of a strong man. Just as the apes want a strong ape, there's a tendency in humans to want a strong human to follow. And of course, that's fraught with the same problems that we have with the strong ape situation. Democracies have a better way of communicating with each other than those who don't even have a democracy. But a healthy democracy depends on these kinds of perspectives being knit together. So there's a sense of union. And at every level we need that. So. In a sense, Europe, the United States, and other democracies have attempted to create that through the UN, United Nations. It's very important to support that. You know, that's the carrying out the philosophy that comes from inner non-communication practice. So, where's the love? Well, it's in you. But the love needs to flow. So with every act of kindness that you partake in today, it's an investment, a laying up of treasure in heaven, in the bliss that you find when you sit in the seat of the artist. Those kinds of spiritual treasures of every act of kindness, with every effort to communicate in these ways in the world, with every effort to create healthy democracies and to defend them. So, will we let the ape-like tendencies overrule our spiritual tendencies, our humane perspectives that advocate greater love? I hope not. Does that get into local politics here and everywhere and other places as well in the world? Yes. You know, someone's walking around telling you they can cure all of your problems. That is the last person you want to follow. They can't do it. They're lying to you. The only real leader for humanity, the only good leader is all of us working together in love. The more we do that, the more we have a peak. at that which is divine. And I will end this presentation with the words Namaste, which I have very variously described, all true, and at the end of every presentation I make. May that love flow in me. Honor that love flow in you. That oneness with the universe that I feel, honor that same in you. May the wonder of all of that in me, honor that same in you. The yogis say, everything comes from bliss and everything returns to bliss. Yes, it comes from the artist, who in its own way is above our dramatic sense of time, appreciating the story we are in, the story of our life, calling us to be more humane. So, Namaste, y'all. And have a really great day.